start out looking at the new 787s. The Japanese airlines, Japan Airlines and ANA, have been milking the 787s for all they're worth in their advertising over here, because they're still the only two airlines in the world that are operating this beautiful new state-of-the-art Boeing aircraft. Now, Hasegawa's done a little bit of something new here with the model. If you take a look over here, you can see that they've added these support parts into the fuselage when you build it, which the guy here explained to me, although they're calling it support parts, it says their main function is actually to make the fuselage parts easy to assemble. They fall right into the proper position very well with these new parts in there. And of course, it's going to help make it a little bit more sturdy, you know, no sag, that kind of thing. He's also explaining to me how the aircraft, you know, if you're anything about airliners, the 787 is unique in that it's got this built-in curve on the outer section of the wings. And the model doesn't have much curve, and he explained that's because this is what the aircraft looks like when it's still on the ground. When it's in flight and when it starts to lose fuel, then of course that wing curve starts to come up. They modeled it as it would look at an airport, for example, if you're not actually taking a look at the model. And of course we started out with the conventional ANA and Japan Airlines markings. It's really good, by the way, to see Japan Airlines bring back their crane, because that's always been, I thought, a really cool logo, and I was disappointed a few years back when they dumped it. Crane's back on 787 for Japan Airlines, but I'm sure we'll see all the other airlines released as well when other airlines around the world start to operate the 787. Shifting gears completely, next to it here we've got Voyager. Yes, Voyager, which I believe has the distinction of being the first man-made object to exit the solar system in a beautiful plastic hit here from Hasegawa. Now, personally, I would have liked to seen it include a few little figures from Star Trek, the motion picture, but I'm kind of dating myself with that one. But we've got Voyager here from Hasegawa as a beautiful science kit. And a few variations here. We've got the new variation of the Shinkai 6500, deep sea exploring submarine, variation of their beautiful 32nd scale Raiden. And then scooting down here, we've got something that's not a variation. In fact, it's not even real. This is the Shinden II. Now this is from a game. This is from Ace Combat Assault Horizon. And the Shinden II, which you can see here, is a really neat concept aircraft. It looks like it actually exists. Obviously the basic form is based on the Japanese Shinden, which was an experimental plane being developed as World War II ended. But the tail assembly and the vector thrust and everything, kind of reminiscent of the F-22. A lot of new features here, and they've even thrown in sort of a Harrier-like function. The aircraft can do VTOL, or short takeoff and landing, with wingtip bends and everything. Now again, it's obviously a fictional airplane, but they pulled out all the stops and are doing a beautiful model of this really neat aircraft design from the game Ace Combat Assault Horizon. Now that's going to be coming out in July of this year. So Hasegawa got a lot of neat stuff in the oven right now.
Brian here at the Hasegawa booth checking out some Macross stuff. As you guys know, Hasegawa has a great selection of Macross items, including the crazy little egg plane Valkyries, as you see down here, and a wide, broad selection of Valkyries and Gerwalks and Batroids and all the cool stuff. Now, some new items they have. This one's coming in July. This is the VF-19A SVF-569 Lightnings. As you can read along with me, this will be a limited edition kit coming out with some different parts designed by 3D computer-aided design and featuring cartograph decals. And we got some photo etch parts also coming out for that. Now, here's another new interesting release, Valkyrie. This is the VF-1A Valkyrie, the Angel Birds. This is the Valkyrie flight demonstration team, kind of riffing on the Blue Angels, Blue Impulse, all, you know, those great flight demonstration teams around the world with all the colorful markings for the Angel Birds. And we also have some photo-etched metal parts coming out for that. And for Captain Harlock fans, we had the Space Wolf came out a while back, but now here is the Space Wolf SW-190 Harlock, or Harlock as we say, the Harlock custom version. Very cool black spaceship as seen in Captain Harlock, which apparently is sometimes spelled H-E, although usually I see it spelled H-A. Hasegawa is going with H-E in this case. So cool Valkyries, cool Harlock custom versions. We've already heard about the super cool Shinden II, so that's some of the great stuff from Hasegawa. Maschinenkrieger, and we got a bunch of it right here, folks, at the Hasegawa booth. You've seen the Falkies and the Nutrocker, Nutcrackers and all this cool stuff. The next one coming up is the Großer Hund Altair, this super cool guy here. And this model here was actually built by Maschinenkrieger designer and creator Yokoyama-san, right there, Yokoyama Kao. So he built that one. So, super cool detail. The machining Krieger Hasegawa combo is rocking the sci-fi modeling world with all these cool kits. And to go along with that, there's another company called the Brickworks, as we see down here, who make an excellent line of 1/20th scale figures. Yeah, by the way, that the previously viewed Großhund Altair is also 1/20th scale. So you see all these cool things here. You'll notice they are mostly very nice young ladies in various poses. We got some kind of a Nazi motif going there with these young ladies dressed up like that. Some other figures coming out are these set of German Shepherds and road cones for dressing up your diorama. So these are all 1/20th scale, great additions to anything 1/20th scale, and including Machinenkrieger.